What's up everybody, my name is Sancus, and in this video we're going to be covering a little sidechain technique which I thought was a pretty cool feature in the standard Ableton compressor. When you use sidechaining there, you have this little feature called an EQ, which will allow you to EQ the signal that you are using for your sidechain signal, and I thought it would be a cool video to kind of demonstrate how you could do this inside of FL Studio. So here we have just a drum beat playing and a bass playing. So the premise of this technique is pretty much gonna apply to drums like this. If you have a loop with a kick and a snare and some hi-hats and you wanna sidechain something by that loop, how can you get the sidechain signal to just be the kick and a snare without the hi-hats over here, without actually taking the hi-hats out? Because you most likely, you know, if you have this bounce down together, want to keep it all part of the same file. So how can we keep this loop intact and sidechain this bass underneath it by this loop without having the bass actually be sidechained by the snare signal here? So let's go ahead and play this example. This is without sidechaining. So not a lot of pumping going on, as a matter of fact, none whatsoever, because we're not sidechaining. So if we go over into our mixer over here, you can see that I've sent it in. This is the drums over here in channel 1, then channel 3 is the bass, which is made in Serum. Just very simple kind of bass for this example, just a spectral wavetable with this pluck on it, being filtered. A tiny amount here, and then just some compression. And an EQ here just to kind of tame it a little bit, and then just an EQ here just to kind of take away some of the highs. And we, of course, we have this limiter here, which is going to be what we're going to be using for the sidechaining. So what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to take our drum signal and we're going to want to send it into another chain, or into another effects mixer, I should say. So default, when you send in your drums in, it should look like this, routed to the master. So what we're going to do is just click on this little arrow down here on channel 2, and we're going to go to channel 2 and make sure that it's not routed to the master. It's going to be routed to the master by default, so we're just going to click this and take this away. And we're also gonna click on the bass routing over here, and we're gonna take this amount down, or alternatively you can just sidechain to this track as well. So now we have a duplicate signal over here, except that it's not outputting any noise, it's just taking the signal from the drums and just sending that signal into the bass channel for sidechaining. And this allows us to process the signal differently than the drums. So what we're going to do is go to our bass over here, we're going to go to the limiter, we're going to go to the compressor, go to sidechain, and choose insert 2, that is the signal, and we're going to take the ratio and threshold down to a point where you will have sidechaining. So if you just play this now like this, you're going to see the purple is representing the ducking that's happening here. So you're going to see a lot of that happening every time the kick, snare, and the hi-hat plays, and the bass is going to feel very inconsistent because of the fact that it's also being sidechained by the hi-hat. See, it just constantly keeps ducking down. So what we can do is we can go to the insert 2 over here and just insert a simple EQ2, and we're going to press the preset window over here, the toggle, or the next preset button I should say, twice, and then we're gonna be greeted with this cool little high and band pass. We're just gonna take the high down until we see that basically we're gonna take a look at this and we're gonna see where the kick and the snare is and where the hi-hat is, and we're just gonna take this down until we are eliminating the hi-hat. So if we just solo this part right here, where just the hi-hat is playing. So it's not perfect, there's still a bit of noise over here as well, which we could solve with a gate. But basically what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this down. The hi-hat is around here, it starts around the upper mids. Gonna take this to around the mids over here. Let's bring the drums back in. You should hear a lot cleaner sidechaining now. Now what we can do is we can go to this insert once again, go to the limiter, let's bring this one up, And we're just going to bring the gain, the threshold up a little bit. We're going to bring the gain down. So that's going to take whatever is below that threshold down in volume. And we're just going to play it and try to eliminate the hi-hats sounds without affecting the drums, the kick and the snare too much. So you can see that it's very, very small here. All we have to do is bring it up around over here, and we are already eliminating all that other noise between the kick and the snare. Now, if we go back to the bass and the limiter over here, we should see that the sidechaining is a lot cleaner. If we just over-exaggerate the effect even more, we should be able to see what it has done here. So that's probably as clean as the sidechain is going to get here. So if we just take the EQ and the limiter on the signal out of the mix and do a little A-B comparison, man, what a difference. Much better. So that's how you would go about doing that. Again, I find the Ableton feature within the compressor and the multiband compressor to be pretty neat that it does that. But of course, it's nothing that we can't do outside of the outside of FL Studio. It's nothing that can only be done outside of FL Studio, I should say. Excuse me. It's definitely possible in FL Studio. It just takes a little bit of routing, and that is the awesomeness of this routing feature that we have here, that we can do such creative things. So even though some limiters, our limiter or our compressor, doesn't have the built-in EQ, it's very easy and actually gives us much more control to do it separately within the routing. So I would say that this is probably a better way than doing it all within a plugin, which of course you can do in other DAWs as well, but this is how you would do that in FL Studio. So I hope you guys enjoyed this little tip in this little video. As usual, thank you very much for watching, and I hope you guys have a great day.